Okay. Hi, everyone. Tears the Knee Fears. Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd. And it's time for a review of the new Deaf Heaven album, Infinite Granite. This is the fifth full-length LP from California rock outfit, Deaf Heaven, a group who at one time was at the forefront of the 2010s American black gaze wave. Now, they were far from the first band to bring together elements of black metal and post-rock and shoegaze, but they brought it to a popularity level that no other band did and most likely ever will. Let's face it though, since Landmark Records like Sunbather, the black gaze trend has kind of come and gone, and it's been interesting seeing the response to that as some bands who helped popularize the sound have pretty much stuck with it, while others have refused to be defined by it with radical shifts in their discography. And I think Infinite Granite is one of those moments. That being said, I don't think this record is that far removed stylistically from the core genres that inspire the band's early works. Post-rock still has a pretty big presence on Infinite Granite, as does shoegaze. Rather than screamo undertones, many of these tracks I think feature emo undertones that run parallel to the moody serenity of like the recent works of American Football. Deaf Heaven here is also embracing dreamier layers of effects and vocal mixes, and for the most part that black metal influence has kind of drifted off into the abyss, with maybe the exception of the final moments of the last track, which feels too little too late at that point anyway, because if I'm being frank here, I think Infinite Granite is a pretty thankless record. And honestly, I think it's got very little to do with this shift in sound the band has undergone here. Rather, I think I can put it squarely on the writing, the performances, and the production. Like, in the abstract, there's no reason that a record pulling together elements of emo and post-rock and shoegaze should be bad inherently, but let me say in my opinion, I think Deaf Heaven is showcasing some of the worst cliches of the genres on this record. Let's begin with the post-rock inspired progressions on nearly all of these tracks. Most of the cuts on Infinite Granite follow a very basic, linear progression from subtle, atmospheric, ethereal verses to distorted bursts of rock instrumentation. It's crescendo core 101. Parts of this LP make me feel like I'm sitting at the tail end of a third wave post-rock Human Centipede, and just like the worst crescendo core out there, every single musical move on this record is telegraphed as hell. I don't even need to listen to it because I can imagine every reverb-soaked rush of guitars in my head already. Sadly, I think this record unconsciously falls into a trap that many bands do when they are performing to the atmosphere they're creating around their music, that being the melodies and chord progressions amounting to drivel because it's more about the size of the sound than it is what you're actually playing, what you're actually writing. But it doesn't need to be this way. There are plenty of classic acts in these schools of shoegaze and post-rock who have grand sounds, great production, but their writing is also compelling too. So these songs being sort of predictable is one thing, but also none of the grand finales on these tracks are as cathartic as the album would imply. Usually there's an attempt at doing something full and thick and distorted to scratch that shoegaze itch, but the walls of sound on these tracks make for a pretty blaring but bland experience, loud but not creatively textured in the slightest. Blaring but bland, it's like slurping down a thin, unseasoned broth at a boiling hot temperature. Then the vocals, which in my opinion are one of the most aggravating aspects of the record, are not very good. They're weak, they're nasally, they're emotionally stiff, and almost always buried in the mix. And across the LP, they come in different flavors of bad, be it on the song In Blur, where they sound almost like something off of a 90s pop rock radio ballad. Some of the quivering vibratos on the track Great Mass of Color make me feel like I'm being haunted by ghosts with a bad Morrissey impression. Then the vocal layering on Lament of Wasps sounds like an out-of-tune male Christian choir doing their thing over an Explosions in the Sky cover band. So yes, once again, production lacking, writing lacking, vocals lacking. I will give this record one thing. The band does attempt to give every crescendo on this LP its own vibe, its own mix of influences, like the black metal influences coming back with a vengeance on the final moments of the closer that I mentioned earlier. The finish on Lament of Wasps is one of the most blissful walls of sound on the LP. Then Villain sees some harsh scrams roars coming back underneath some sparkling waves of guitar. But as much as in my mind I can separate these various explosions in sound on the record, the buildups to all of these points is just absolutely mind-numbing. So it's almost like the variation doesn't even really matter all that much. Especially since none of these tracks overcome the core issues I've been harping on up until this point, which I will spare you. I won't reiterate them for the conclusion of this review, but I will say it's a damn shame that this record came out as dull and uninspired as it did. Feeling a light to decent three on this one. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well over here next to my head. It's another video you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Deaf Heaven, forever.